Hi, Canada. I'm Wes Mack, and I'm bringing you my country voice. I'm going to answer some of your questions. So we have Brianna Lynn Lucibello on Facebook, and she has asked, how old were you when you first sang? Now, technically, I've seen photographs of myself standing on a guitar while wearing a diaper and smacking it, so I mean, I don't know if that really constitutes singing. I believe I would have done some musicals as a, like, you know, 6 or 7 year old. My first band I would have started and played when I was about 13, and there's a fantastic video of the three of us singing, and none of our voices have broken yet as we cover a bunch of unknown songs. So that would probably be the first time I was singing.
I ain't looking for a good girl. I like a little bit of misbehaving. And I don't know if you're a bad girl, but you're a whole lot of wild and a little bit of crazy.
Kelsey Heinen on Twitter asks, what is one of your must-haves when you're on tour? I feel pants come to mind. You gotta have those. But I think my band would point out that I apparently run on Tim Hortons ice caps, like they're gasoline, even though they're notoriously probably should be bad for your voice. I probably drink a fair number of those. So we'll go with that as a must-have.
Girl, I love the way you let me down, do it rough. Girl, I love the way you mess me up. Show up late, start a fight. Tell me you hate me, then stay the night.
Christina Arsenault on Twitter asks, what's your favorite Shania song? And of course, the answer is that don't impress me much, because though I don't own much myself, Leopard Print is fantastic. At ShaniaLove11 on Twitter asks, what is one of the greatest things Shania has taught you so far? I think a lot of that is more in what she actually does than any, you know, sit-me-down sort of lesson. I think she's fantastic at bringing a huge show, you know, a massive production, but when you hear her speak between songs and, like, you know, sort of her interactions with her fans, it's very genuine. It doesn't seem, it's not contrived, it's very, you know, you can see her actually thinking her way through it every time, and I appreciate that. I think it's one of the great things of her career is that she's always seemed, as much as she can have all the flash, that she is still very accessible and connects really well and cares about her fans. So that's something I think everyone can learn from.
I make plans, you don't show up. I get alone, I can't get enough. I guess you kind of giving me a run around. Girl, I love the way you let me down, do it rough. Girl, I love the way you mess me up.
Debbie Roy or Wah, I apologize if I've minced your name in either direction, from Facebook asks, what's your favorite place to play on tour? I don't know that I have a soft spot in my heart, though I've never played there, for the Calgary Saddle Dome, because I grew up going and seeing a lot of concerts there. I hope to one day play there. We didn't get to do the Calgary stop on this run, but I'll be back. For places I have played, out in Vancouver, the Commodore Ballroom, it's a, you know, 1,000-person venue or something, and the first time I opened for Florida Georgia Line there, it's an intimate setting, and yet it also, you know, you'll have some larger acts roll through there. That's probably one of my favorite places to play. Thank you so much for all the questions, guys, and let's chat soon.
I get in my truck and come around, girl. Call me up, 'cause girl, I love the way.